Blessed evening, 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 blessed evening. For this is the day that the Lord He has made. I shall rejoice and I shall be glad in it. Welcome to the Monday Night Live. We give God praise and honor and glory, for God is worthy of the praise. God deserves all of the honor, all of the glory. It belongs to Him. Blessed evening, blessed evening. I ask that you please just share the live, watch parties, whatever it is that you can do, please share the live so that we can get more people joined in on the live tonight. I just want to give God praise and honor because God is good and He's worthy of the praise. You know, I almost didn't make it on here tonight, and you know me, I love to be very transparent. I'll get in more detail later. I'm trying to share this somewhere while I'm preparing, so just bear with me one second. Love to be very transparent. My video is echoing in the background, so I just want to. Blessed evening, everybody, to all that's joining. I ask that you please share the live. Please share the live. I'm still looking for my scripture. I haven't found it yet. But I do know the topic, and the topic is don't give up. And the reason I say don't give up, because you're close. So I'm going to play a song by Marvin Sapp called, I believe Marvin Sapp called Close. But before I do that, I want to pray. And then I'll come back and I'll talk about, you know, my delay and the time and just so many things going on. But I want you to hold on. Don't give up because you're close. And you're closer than what you think. And I believe me sharing my testimonies and the things that I go through and me being transparent helps a lot of people to understand that as people, we go through challenges and we go through situations. But it's very important that we hold on to the Lord. Right. No matter what, if you got to cry, let it out. If you got to scream, scream, but don't give up on God because you're close. So tonight I encourage you, do not give up. I'm going to pray before we begin our song. I'm going to play the song and then we'll come back into the teaching. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight for M&L. God, it is Monday Night Live. God, we pray that you bless, that you strengthen, that you give us, God, whatever it is that we need and that we desire, that we leave from this live tonight full of abundance. God, I humbly, sacrificially, and full-heartedly give me to you right now at this very moment. God, and I ask that you have your way. Have this way through me, through this live. God, I pray that the Holy Spirit begins to touch the minds of your people, that it begins to empower, God, all those that are in need of you, your strength, your love, whatever it is that they desire. God, I pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus that you have your way. God, help the words that I say be an edification to the souls of your people. God, I am your puppet. Use me at your will. God, manipulate every string, every tongue, every word. God, everything that I speak, God, I give myself to you right now in this moment. Have your way, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. So I'm going to play this song. I was listening to it today and it touched me. And I just felt in my spirit, this is what the Monday Night Live is for tonight. So we're close. You must be close to my destiny, extremely close to my victory, because here comes trials and troubles and jealousy and envy. I must be close. What God has for me, I must be close. To my overflow, extremely close to my miracle. Please share the live, because here comes confusion, problems, and enemies. I just believe I must be close to what God has for me. Don't give up. Don't give up, because you're close. You're close. To whom much is given, much is required. The qualified must go through the fire. You won't smell like smoke when you come out. You're going to be better than you were before. Yes, Lord. I must be close. Push through. Close. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. You're close to your overflow. You're extremely close to your miracle. Because here comes confusion and the problems and the enemies and the jealousy. So you must be close. Extremely close. To what God has for you. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give in. Don't let go of the Lord. Don't let go of him. You're close. You won't be swayed. Don't be swayed by the obstacles that you face. Stay in the race. Don't give up. What you have for me. I'll go through it.
I'll go through it.
I'll go through it.
I'll
just believe.
I must be
close. I must be close.
So close to it.
So close to
it. Why don't y'all help me sing? Sing with me.
I'll go through it. Don't give up. Go through it. Hold on to the Lord. Don't let go of him. He got you. No matter how hard it is, no matter how much the burden may weigh, don't give up. Because you're close. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. It might be hard sometimes, but God made us a promise. So tonight I come to encourage. We thank God for the M&L night. I thank God for that song. You know, it says I must be close, extremely close, because here comes trials and confusion and jealousy and envy. So that means I must be close to what God has for me. So tonight I want to encourage you, don't give up. Why? Because you're close. You're close to what God has for you. And I heard when he said the scripture, to whom much is given, much is required. So, you know, a lot of times we go through stuff and I'm gonna get back to my transparent moment in just a minute. But we go through things and, you know, we don't understand, Lord, why is it me that has to go through this? God, I am loving people. I'm giving my all. I'm being obedient to your word. I'm going to church every time the doors are open. I'm kneeling down before you. I'm doing the best that I can. But the thing is that if you did not propose a threat to the kingdom of hell, you would not be on the front line. But what you have to understand is that in order for God to elevate you, you're going to go through some things. And when God has something ordained over your life, the word we just said, to whom much is given, much is required. Now, some people go through a little bit of stuff and they just quick temper. We're not talking about these quick tempered moments that, you know, some of us have. We're not talking about that. We're talking about where every day something keep happening. Somebody got something to say. You did something wrong. You hurt this person's feelings. You weren't even there, but this person mad. You walk in the room. Everybody got an attitude. People got to talk to you because, you know, you talking about God and then your children acting up. Your finances ain't right. You're getting all these notices in the mail, your email blowing up, your bank account negative. All these things are going on, but just hold on. Don't give up because you're close to what God has for you. See, we cannot get weak and weary. We got to continue to pray. The Bible says men ought to pray and faint not. So when things get hard, take some time out to keep seeking the Lord. Get down on your hands and knees and ask the Lord for strength to make it through. Ask the Lord to bring you out. I'm going to be very open with you guys tonight. You know, I don't tell my business, but I give a synopsis of what's going on. You know, I've been going through certain things, and I shared a video about a prophet who gave a message about when you get a prophecy, a prophetic word over your life, here comes confusion, trials, enemies. Because the enemy wants to keep you from your destiny. So yesterday I got a wonderful prophetic word, and I thank the Lord for it. It was some things said that only I would know, so I knew that that was the Holy Spirit speaking. Well, today it was like hell on earth from the moment I woke up this morning from the 5:30 a.m. prayer. Complications. This is going wrong. That's going. And when I don't say in one area, I mean in so many different areas of my life. Well, you know, I began to cry, you know, and I had to hold it in and suck it up. And I, you know, I couldn't let it out during the day. You got to hold it in. But when I came home, I was in the bathroom and I just sat there and I began to cry because I needed a release. And I heard the Lord say to me, don't give up because you're too close. If you give up, so many people are going to give up. You can't give up. So you got to realize that when there is a calling on your life, when you're chosen to do the will of the Lord, the things that God has ordained you to do don't come easy. They come with a cost. See, a lot of people like to say, oh, I got favor. I'm blessed and I'm highly favored. Well, baby, let me tell you something. Being blessed and highly favored is not free. Having favor comes with a cost. As we said, the scripture says, to whom much is given, much is required. I ask that you please share the live. If you're watching me in a group or if you're watching me anywhere, please share the live. More people need to understand the importance of not giving up because we're close. You know, to whom much is given, much is required. So, you know, you see yourself in a situation where you're going to church, you're being obedient, you're coming to Bible study, you're praying, you're fasting, you're doing all these things that the word requires of you. But yet, here comes obstacles, here come tests, here comes financial problems. Your spouse ain't acting right, your children cutting up in school, people taking what you say out of context, you know, your friends sensitive in their feelings, or something going on with your friends, or, you know, your work things going on at your job. But tonight I come to encourage you, don't give up because you're close. See, the closer you get to what God has for you, the more obstacles that you're going to have to hurdle. See, to whom much is given, much is required. So the blessings that God has upon your life don't come easy. They come with a cost. See, sometimes people say, oh, you know, God bless me. God bless me. I got a big car and I got this and I got that and I got this and I got that. And oh, and God is so good. You know, the devil blesses too. You got to know where your blessings come from, right? But understand that as you're in the heat of the moment, let's talk about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They went into the fiery furnace, right? The three of them, because they were worshiping the Lord. But when they went in there, they went into the fire. But see, Jesus was in the fire with them. They weren't by themselves. And when they came out, they didn't even smell like smoke. Nothing on them was burnt. They didn't have any, you know, fragrance of any smell, no nothing. And see, right now you're in the fiery furnace. You're there. And you're going through. Every day, every time you turn around, it's something. Every time you go here, it's something. Every time you take 2-3 steps forward, it seems like 20 of them knocking you back. See, I should see way more responses in this because I know that I'm talking to a lot of people. I ain't just talking to myself tonight. But see, sometimes we don't want people to know that we going through. We prefer to keep it to ourselves. But see, that's where we get hindered. That's where we get blockage because God needs you to cry out to him. Don't give up because you're close. Everything that is being presented before you is just something to elevate you. Let's not even give the devil any credit. Learn how to speak out of your mouth the abundance from what God has for you. So God needs you to keep pushing. Don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. And I'm going to tell you today, I said, God, I didn't choose this. Prophet told me yesterday, Bishop told me yesterday, you didn't ask for this, Yvette. Pastor Yvette, you didn't ask for this. No, I didn't. Sometimes I'm like, Lord, you know, I appreciate you choosing me, but sometimes I tell you, I wish you could have chose somebody else. I'm just being honest. But the thing is that you cannot give up because God designed you for a purpose. God created you for a purpose. And if the road was easy, you wouldn't be able to get through it. You know why? Because you wouldn't want to. So the thing is that when God presents challenges, it's because he has his mercy upon you. When God keeps putting obstacles before you, it's because God is giving you his loving and divine grace. Learn how to say, God, I can't do this. I need your help. God, I'm going through. I'm struggling. I don't know which way to go, but God, I know I need your help. God, I'm going through situations, but God, I know that I'm close because here comes confusion. Here comes trial. Here comes obstacles. And I don't know what to do, but God, all I know how to do is trust you. Don't give up. I know it gets hard. I know that you feel like this is it. I'm tired. God, I can't take it no more. And right in the midst of despair, the word says that weeping, it may endure for a night, but God's joy, it comes in the morning. So that means that if you don't give up, don't throw in the towel. Don't let your circumstances get the best of you. Don't allow a moment that you're experiencing for you to become that moment. Instead, continue to fall down on your knees and pray. Continue to become more intimate with God. Continue to push. Continue to pray. Prioritize the righteousness around you and know that God is your strength. God is your refuge. God is the source that you need in order to make it. Yes, it's hard. I understand. Yes, you want to give up, but don't give up because you're close to what God has for you. And I'm coming tonight to prophesy it to your life to say, don't give in to the temptations of the enemy because you are right there at the point of a breakthrough and the door that God is getting ready to open for you, no man or woman could ever close. So don't give up. Don't give up. Don't throw in that towel. Pick the towel up and ask Jesus to drag you if you got to. Let him drag you to your purpose, but do not give up for what God has for you because when you get there, you're going to say, God, I almost gave up. I was right in the middle of a breakthrough and I thought it wasn't going to happen, God. So I almost gave up. But if you just hold on and don't give up, God will keep you. He'll keep you. You sit and contemplate, is your life worth it? Your life is worth so much more than what you've realized. God has purpose for you. God has a plan for you. And that plan is not to destroy you. The word says, God speaks and says, for I know the plans that I have for you. Those plans are to prosper you, never to hurt nor to harm you. Plans to provide you hope and a future. So do not give up. No matter what, thank you, Lord, no matter what it is that you're going through, no matter what problems has been faced before you. Today I said, Lord, what is going on? What is going on? It's coming from everywhere. And I know you guys feel the same. No matter what you do, no matter how hard you keep pushing, it's always something, but I come to encourage you. If I don't give up, you're not going to give up either. So if you gotta cry, cry. It's okay to cry. Cry out to God. Cry out to the Lord. Stop allowing people to make you think that crying is something bad. I didn't say whine. I said cry. there is a difference. But know that if you keep pushing, if you keep seeking God, know that God will supply all of your needs. God is a God that will never lie and he will never fail. But don't you give up, because God is faithful to perform. He's faithful to perform. And know that God is doing a great work in your life. So no matter what you go through, no matter what you face, no matter how much you feel like this is the end and it's not worth it, and God, I'm tired of struggling. God, I'm tired of my kids acting up. Lord, I'm tired of people talking about me. God, I give my heart. I give my all. God, they use me all up. God, they pull from me. They tugging from me left and right. The more I give, the more they take. God, they don't want to use me. They pushing me over here in the corner till they ready to use me out. Listen, don't give up. Don't give up. Keep walking in the abundance of the Lord. Do not allow your moment to become who you are. It's okay to have a moment, but you can't become the moment. And you got to learn how to not react to everything that happens. Today I was presented with a situation. And, you know, some people don't like when they say stuff to you that you don't react. You know, you don't respond. The Bible says a prudent man is a wise man. I'm just saying, right? A lot of times some people say silence is the best response. No, it's not. It's not necessarily that silence is the best response, because some people be ignoring you on purpose to get you angry. But being wise about your reaction is the best result. Being wise about what you speak. See, sometimes we react emotionally where we don't allow ourselves any type of logistics to, you know, develop in our brains to be able to process something logistical and spiritual, because we react too emotionally all the time. We take everything so personal. But the thing is that we got to allow God to push us forward. And to whom much is given, much is required. I keep saying that because that's our scripture for tonight. So when the Lord has ordained you to carry a lot, to be a lot, to be great, you got to realize that comes with a cost. Look at Jesus. Jesus couldn't conduct himself any kind of way. He never sinned, but yet he died for all of ours. Don't give up, because there's hope down that road that you're on. That journey that you're on, it gives you hope. That journey that you're on is going to give you strength. That journey that you're on is going to push you to a new level. That journey that you're on that the enemy keeps trying to push you off is going to be that journey that you're going to look back over your life and say, God, I made it. But don't you give up. Because if you give up, you're not going to make it. So don't give up, because you're close. And that song says, how do I know I'm close? I got to be close, because here comes confusion. Here comes problems. Here comes trials, envy, jealousy. I got to be close to what God has for me. So on tonight, I encourage you, don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. If you got to throw the towel, throw it and ask Jesus to catch it. And ask Jesus to drag you to your destiny. But don't you give up. Don't you quit. Don't you back down. No matter what comes, trust and know that God will make a way. That the Lord is a God that does exceedingly and abundantly all things. That he's spoken his word that you are above and not beneath. That you are the head and not the tail. That you are more than a conqueror. And Jesus, it says that we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. You know why you're having some trouble doing some stuff? Because you're trying to do it on your own. It didn't say you could do all things. It says you could do all things through Christ that strengthens you. So if you want to be strengthened, so that you don't throw in the towel, If you want to be strengthened so that you don't go through trials and tribulations, if you want to be strengthened so that you are able to see what the Lord has for you, continue to trust God. Continue to know that God is with you. Continue to know that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. You got to learn how to speak to your storm. Yes, it's going to get hard. Yes, it's going to be unbearable at times, but go into your secret place and spend time with the Lord. Give God the cry that you need to let out. Give God that praise that you need to let out. Give it to God and watch him work on your behalf. Don't you give up. Keep pushing. No matter how hard it gets, don't give up. Don't give in. Do not allow what the enemy designed to break you to shift you from what God created to elevate you. Because God is a God that elevates. He increases. He moves you forward. But it comes with a cost. So many people walk around talking about, you know, I'm favored. I'm blessed. And I'm blessed and I'm highly favored and the Lord's abundance is upon me, but they don't realize what comes with that. And it doesn't come easy. It's not easy territory, right? So I encourage you tonight, do not give up. Do not throw in the towel. Keep asking the Lord for strength. Keep asking the Lord for guidance. Keep asking the Lord to push you, keep you on task, keep you focused, keep you moving forward, because know that you're close. So because you're close, this is why all these problems and situations are taking place in your life, because you're close. I'm sorry, my hair is at my face. I'm messing it up. Okay, I'm leaving it alone. You're close. Don't think that this journey is going to be easy. Acts 14:22, I believe, says that in order to see the kingdom of heaven, we will suffer. It's not easy, but it's worth it. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't listen to that voice whispering in your ear. I keep saying that voice is whispering because it ain't got enough power to be bold. So it's whispering. Like a snake, kill it, cut the head off, bind Satan in the name of Jesus. I even contemplated about doing the live tonight. When I finish this live, boy, I'm going into a deep prayer and prostrate. I'm stretched out praying to the Lord because I need this spirit that is trying to attack me to flee. And when I lay there, I pray unto the Lord until I feel it move. But I know that I'm close. You might be getting hit in your marriage right now. Seek the Lord. Ask God to help you. It's never too late to come to the Lord. You're never in a place where God can't bring you out. Your children are being disobedient, being disruptive. Bring it to the Lord in prayer. I'm sorry. Share the live. Please share the live. We are on prayer every day of the week except for Sunday, because I'm in somebody's church on Sunday till I get my own. I'm just saying. You got to fellowship. You got to be around people that's in the same position as you, that they strive to seek more of the Lord, that they're desiring to be closer to God. If you got people in your life that are not willing to move forward, people that are in your life that are not willing to shift, that they're not seeking the Lord, then you got to shift them people to the side. I'm sorry, you guys. My sinus is acting up. Don't give up. I know it's rough. I know it's hard. I almost didn't even come on here. I was like, God, I don't know. I think I'm going to just pray. I didn't get no confirmation on that from God. So here I am. I didn't want to do the Monday Night Live. I'm just being honest. I didn't want to do it. I'm going through too much. But Psalms 37:3 says, trust in the Lord and do good. And know that ye shall always be fed, and that ye shall dwell in the land forever. That's one of our scriptures that we say when we close the morning encouragement. And I say that because that scripture helps me to understand that when I'm going through, put my energy into somebody else. So that way it takes so much focus off of what I'm going through. Don't you give up. God bless you. Whatever it is that you're going through, right now I'm getting ready to pray. And I ask that you open your heart and your mind. Talk to God. Whatever it is that you're going through, whatever it is that you're dealing with, give it to the Lord. Ask him for strength. Ask him for guidance. Psalms 37:3. Trust in the Lord and do good. And know that ye shall always be fed and that ye shall dwell in the land forever. Psalms 37:3. 37:1 says, fret not yourself of evildoers. That means don't get consumed of what people are doing against you. Don't fret yourself with what people are doing. Instead, trust in God and do good. And know that when you do good, that you'll always be fed and that you will dwell in the land forever. God's promises will fulfill itself over your life. Tonight, I declare and decree in the mighty name of Jesus that every promise that the Lord has for us will be fulfilled. Everything that God has given to us, we will walk in the promises of the Lord. And I ask that you open your hearts and your minds right now as I begin to pray, that whatever you have that you need the Lord to strengthen you with, whatever you have that you desire of the Lord to bring you out of, tonight is the night that we lay it down for the Lord to do a mighty move on our behalf. Whatever it is that you're dealing with, your finances, your household, lack of peace, too much confusion, remember, don't give up because you're close. But we're still going to lay these things at the altar. You could be having a congregation that won't appreciate you. And for those of you that do not know, this month is Pastor Appreciation Month. So whatever pastor that you're connected to, appreciate them. Send them some love. They need encouragement too. We need encouragement too. Excuse me. I apologize. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight. God, we give you praise. God, we give you honor and we give you glory. God, we thank you for being a wonderful, awesome, and amazing God. Tonight, we come before you, God, and we declare and we decree that whatever it is that we're fighting, God, we're fighting because we're close to what you have for us. We're fighting because, God, we're close to our destiny. We're close to our promise. God, some of us are battling health complications. God, some of us are battling divorce. God, some of us are battling lack of peace. God, in the midst of confusion, some of us are walking, portraying an image of which we're not living in. Some of us, God, are going through financial situations. Some of us are going through, God, facing being put out of our homes or losing our cars. God, some of us are facing, God, dysfunctional relationships with friends and wives and spouses and significant others. God, some of us are facing situations with our children. But God, on tonight, I declare and decree that we will walk in the abundance of your glory and your grace. That God, we ask that you open up the floodgates of heaven right now. God, and that you pour in a blessing in us, God, that we don't have room enough to contain. God, that for every attack of the enemy, God, we bind it right now in the name of Jesus, God, and we speak peace, God, we speak life, God, we speak abundance, as your word says that we shall live and not die. So on tonight, God, we walk, God, in what you have for us, God. Everything that is trying to stop us, God, from fulfilling our destiny, God, we send it back to the pits of hell from which it has come. No weapon formed against us shall prosper, God. Whatever it is that you're grooming inside of us, that you're developing inside of us to give birth to, God, I speak to the wounds right now. And I command in the name of Jesus that everything that is growing inside of your people to give birth to, God, that you give us the determination and the strength not to give up so that we can push, God, into the promises that you have for us, so that we can push, God, into the purpose that you have ordained for us. God, we believe in your word. God, because you are our shepherd, we shall not want. God, you make us to lie down in green pastures. So God, we pray right now that even when we walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, God, that we will fear no evil because you are with us. So God, even when we feel like giving up, God, give us the strength to keep moving. God, even when we feel like it's too much to bear, God, give us the strength not to give up. God, give us hope, God, in the midst of despair. God, give us peace in the midst of confusion. God, for that mother that is struggling, trying to provide for her children. God, open a door. God, touch someone's heart to give and give sacrificially. God, for that man that is trying to provide for his home. God, send a blessing, God. Help him out, God, for the families that are struggling. God, we pray that the abundance of your son Jesus fall upon them right now. God, I speak right now to cardiac arrest in the name of Jesus. God, there's somebody that's dealing with heart failure. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. God, we command right now, God, in the name of Jesus, that every blood cell that flows through the heart begin to flow like never before. God, that it begins to move and pump blood, God, like it has never done. God, and that heart begins to regulate. God, that it begins to process, God, and do what it needs to do so that the rest of the body will function. God, we ask to be purified on tonight. God, we've laid every care and every cast that we have. God, everything that is going on, God, we lay it at the altar right now in the name of Jesus. Every care, every casting, God, that is coming against us, everything that we're walking through, God, every enemy, God, everything that is attacking us, God, because we're close, God, we can't give up. God, and I know what it means of casting. The enemy is casting things amongst us. But God, we lay it at the altar. God, we bind every demon of suicide right now in the name of Jesus. God, and we speak life. God, we pray that you interfere in every suicide attack on someone's life right now. Help leaders to understand that they are not to encourage people, that it is okay to take their lives because of grace and mercy, because God, that is not of you. God, so we pray right now that we walk in truth. God, that we help people to love. God, to be able to love themselves. God, we need love to abound in your people. So God, give us the strength not to give up. God, give us the strength not to give up. God, give us the strength not to give up. God, let us begin to cry out to you, seeking for you, Jehovah Jireh, our provider. God, you are Elohim, God, and we ask, God, for your strength. God, you are El Shaddai, God, and we ask for your mercy. So God, keep us covered. God, keep us pushing. God, keep us steadfast in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, God, to whom much is given, much is required. God, give us the weight, God, where we uplift our shoulders saying, God, it's so much that we have to carry. But, God, we know that we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. So, God, in the name of Jesus, God, we speak right now abundance. God, we speak right now peace. God, we speak right now in the mighty name of Jesus that every lip that comes against us, that every tongue that attempts to condemn us in judgment, oh, God, we ask that you have mercy upon them. God, continue to shift our atmosphere, Lord God. Continue to keep us. Don't give up. We are walking into the prophet coming out of despair. So know that God is with you. God, for the person that's crying. God, for the person that just lost something. God, for the person that's facing losing something. God, we ask that you dispatch angels right now. Divine angels in the name of Jesus that come and shift the atmosphere. That come and bless, Lord God, and strengthen in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we give you praise, honor, and glory tonight because, God, you deserve it. And we pray these wonderful and blessed things unto your holy and majesty. In Jesus' blessed name we pray. To God be the glory. Don't give up. Don't give up. You're close. You're close to your destiny. So here comes confusion. Here comes trials, troubles, envy, jealousy. It's okay. You'll make it. But don't you give up. Don't you give up and don't you give in. Because what God has for you is much greater than the block that's standing before you. See, the block is there, but you can speak to that mountain. You can speak to that block in the name of Jesus. God is giving you power and authority. Believe what God has for you. I know that it gets hard. I know that it sometimes feels that it's unbearable. But know that God is with you and he will see you through. Don't give up. Don't give up. God bless you. We thank you for joining M&L Night, from Family Media Ministries to your home, to your house, to your car, wherever you are. We thank you for being a part of us, for listening to the Monday Night Live. I try to come on here every Monday and give the Monday Night Live. And I will say that tonight I said it before, I almost didn't make it. I didn't want to do it, but I was obedient. I didn't want to do it. Not that God told me it was okay for me not to do it. So don't give up. Keep doing what God has created you to do. Keep pushing and trusting in the Lord, knowing that God is going to see you through. There's nothing that is impossible for the Lord. God is a God that can do all things but fail. He didn't create you to give up. He created you to be more than a conqueror. So that means whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through, whatever your trials, whatever your tribulations, whatever's weighing upon you, know that you will make it. Don't give up. We're here for you. If you need prayer, join us. I have flyers on my page. Look for Yvette Hall, Family Media Ministries Incorporated. Our website, familymediaministries.org. You can find us there. If the Lord has placed upon your heart to sow a seed, you can do so by going to our website. Again, it's familymediaministries.org. We're on Facebook, we're on Instagram, we're on Twitter, Family Media Ministries. If you want to follow me, you can. Yvette Hall. I do morning encouragement every morning, Monday through Friday, between 8 and 8:30. And know that the Lord really blesses, because some people think I'm doing the morning encouragement for them. I am, but I'm also doing it for me, because I too need to be encouraged. Don't give up. It's hard. It seems like every time you turn around, it's something else. But keep smiling. Keep trusting in God. And if you got to cry out to God, cry out to him. Don't let anyone make you feel like there's something wrong with crying out to God. Break yourself away from old traditions and religion. Those things are keeping God's people in captivity. We need to be free, right? So no more walking in religion. But we're walking in the word of God. Love your enemy as you love yourself. Obey God's commandments. Don't give up and don't give in, because you're close to what God has for you. God bless you. I appreciate you. Keep your head up and know that you matter. That you matter, that you're important, and you mean something. And if you haven't looked yourself in the mirror today and told yourself how great you are, let me be the first to tell you. You're great. You're wonderfully and fearfully made. So don't you give up. And know, if you try to throw in the towel, I'm going to pick it up and I'm going to smack you with it and give it back to you. I'm just saying. God bless you. I love you. Have a blessed night, and continue to pray, to fast, to praise, and study your word. Listening to me is not enough. You have to make a one-on-one relationship with God. And before we go, I hear in my spirit, If you do not know our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, I invite you right now to accept him into your heart and into your life. And it's very easy. All you got to do is say, God, I accept you. Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Use me at your will. Forgive me for my sins and my trespasses. Very simple. Don't take a lot. Never let somebody make you feel that, you know, if you don't have a three-piece suit, you can't go to church. The devil is a lie. Okay. The word says, come as you are. Don't miss out on what God has for you because you're listening to people. You want to be taught on what to do? Get in the word. The word is a discerner. The word is wisdom. And the word is power. God bless you. Stay encouraged. And remember to encourage someone today. Have a blessed night, everybody. God bless you.